You know, the English author Douglas Adams often recounts a story that happened to him in the 1970s. He arrived at a train station early, wanting to relax before he caught his train, went into a local cafe, sat down, ordered something to drink, got himself a package of cookies and a newspaper, and then looked around and found an ordinary looking gentleman, and he went over and sat at his table and put everything down and pulled out his newspaper to try to look for a crossword puzzle to pass the time. Well, he had no sooner started to do this than the gentleman across the table reaches over, opens up the package, and takes out a cookie. And he's thinking to himself, well, wait a second, what, that's my cookie. And so he didn't know how to react, so he did what a lot of us would do. We just quietly sat there, and then pretty soon the gentleman reached over and took another one. And he said, well, so he moved things around, and he reached over and he took one. And then the gentleman took another one. And then he took another one. And they did this back and forth till pretty soon the package was empty. And so they sat there for a little bit while, and much to his relief, the gentleman finally got up and left. And he sat there thinking, how could somebody sit down in plain daylight and steal somebody's cookies? Well, the train came, and he went to gather up his stuff, and as he picked up his newspaper, he looked underneath the newspaper, and there it was, a package of cookies. Unopened. You guessed it. He was the one that was stealing the gentleman's cookies from across the table. You know, now think about it for just a moment. How did that man's perspective change in that moment? You know, he originally felt he was the victim, only to realize a little bit later that he was the cookie thief. His complete perspective was completely wrong. You know, perspective is a point of view. I would call it a frame of reference or an interpretation of the world and the way things work. Think about it. It's intrinsically tied to your identity. It's based upon our experiences and awareness. It is a reflection of the way that we identify ourselves and others. It's like a two-way filter. It focuses and interprets our sensory inputs, everything that's going on around us, and it shapes the way that we react to everything that's going on around us. And it's constructed from what? From our experiences. Our experiences, our traditions, a little bit of social grooming, choosing, and then that in turn creates our actions and reactions. Therefore, our actions, would it be safe to assume that our actions are merely a reflection of our perspective? Looking back, I've often bristled at an inconvenience or a frustration, only to later realize that that experience or that obstruction, that obstacle turned out to be or could have been of great benefit to myself and maybe even to others. So I think recognizing our own limited perspective is a critical step in our own personal growth.